गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास, अ न्यू डे विथ अ न्यू चैप्टर। टुडे वी विल डू अ न्यू चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 2, GUI ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम एंड इंट्रोडक्शन। नाउ GUI, व्हाट इज GUI फुल फॉर्म? ग्राफिकल यूजर इंटरफेस। Now, what is this? Before knowing what is GUI, let us understand what is operating system OS. Now, see, just read your chapter. I have already given you the PDF of chapter 2. You can read this one. Let me explain you what is there in this chapter. Introduction. Have you ever noticed how different tasks at your home are done so well? So that means the book is asking you to think that how all the work at your home, whether making the breakfast, cleaning the house, preparing the lunch, preparing you for your studies, preparing the dinner, and getting everything inset, how it has been done? It is done because it is because your parents manage all the work at home. Some of your mother stays at home as a housewife. She takes care of you and your family, and your father go for his job. Where some of your in the family, the mother and father, both the parents are working people, they goes out. Maybe you are with your granny or grandpa and you be with them, but everything what you required, what you need are ready for you. It is only because your parents keep ready for you, because they manage everything for you. So the computer is made up of different parts and does different kinds of works at home, like at a time. Like your parents does work at home for you, similarly computer also does different types of work at a time. It also requires a manager for it. So whether when you are typing, understanding, drawing, coloring, saving a documents, printing a documents, playing a games, understanding the game, how to play that game, what are the requirement needed to play that game, whether a remote controller or joystick or just with a keyboard you can play. So everything computer can understand. To make computer understand, it needs a manager. The manager is a computer. The manager in a computer is called the operating system. So the manager in the computer is known as the operating system. The operating system manage each and every activity of a computer or in a computer. Operating system is a software that helps you to operate the computer system. Operating system is a software that helps you to operate the computer system through its various function. It controls and manages the different parts of computer system. It acts as an interface between the user and the computer system. So operating system act as an interface. Operating system act as an interface between the user and the computer. So whatever the user needs, whatever the user want to do, suppose you want to draw an apple in Paint, MS Paint. So you need to open MS Paint. So computer knows that the screen of MS Paint, how it looks like, it brings in front of you. Then you start drawing. You select a pencil or a brush and then you draw. So computer understand what you have selected, a pencil or a brush. When you draw, the color you use, red color, green color, yellow color, which color you're using. Suppose you're drawing an apple, so definitely you will use red color. The computer understands that you have chosen red color. So when you pull the brush, you get the red color. So computer understands, so that you are a user, and computer system works according to your wish, and this what you wish and what computer shows in between both of you, the operating system act as a manager to understand and to show your result. There are different operating system. Some of the operating system, popular operating system are, some of the popular operating system are MS-DOS, MS Windows, Unix, Linux, Mac OS, or Mac OS you can call it. So the first one we have MS-DOS, Microsoft Disk Operating System. The full form is Microsoft Disk Operating System, MS Windows, Unix, Linux, and Mac OS. So these are the few popular operating system. User interface. Operating system provide an interface through which the user communicate with a computer system. So OS, the operating system, act as an interface through which or by which you can interact with a computer system. Let us understand this with the help of an example. Suppose you want to save a document on a computer, what will you do? Surely you will give instruction to the computer. To give instruction for saving a document, you need to type some commands, press a set of keys, or click a few buttons. This command or menus through which a user communicate with the computer system are called user interface, or simply interface. So you need to talk with computer, and you want the computer to do certain thing, and to tell the computer what to do, you need an interface. For example, when the president of China and the president of India talk with each other, the Indian president have a problem to understand the Chinese language, whereas the Chinese president will have a problem to understand Hindi. To make these two people understand, they need an interpreter. He is a person who knows both the language, Chinese as well as Hindi, very well, and when a Chinese president speaks, he interpret it to Hindi to the Indian president, whereas when the Indian president speaks in Hindi, he interpret that Hindi language into Chinese to the Chinese president. So the interpreter makes both the president understand in their language and what they are talking. Similarly, OS, the operating system, act as an interface between the user and the computer system, so that what we want, it tells to the computer system, and what computer system shows, it shows us on the screen as an output. So OS act as an interpreter or interface between the two. Types of user interface. There are many two types of user interface: CUI, character user interface; GUI, the graphical user interface. CUI, in a character user interface, the user interact with the computer system by typing commands, for example DOS and Unix. So CUI, the character user interface, here you have to remember lots of commands to command the computer to get your result done. Suppose you want to see a page or turn a page, okay, so you need to type a command known as dir/p. So When in the command prompt, when you type this dir/p, you can see a page dir/w widthwise dir suppose o to open some certain thing, p is there, then I have already said about p. So different commands are there, and many commands are there which you have to remember to see or to want the computer to enact. But in GUI, the options are there in front of you on the screen. You need to select only. You just to take your mouse, click on that option, and you can get your work done. Suppose you want to turn a page, so you, if you click on next, so you will get to go to the next page. Or suppose you want to get a page print out, so you can just give the command print, your page will be printed. GUI is a graphical user interface. The user can use a mouse to interact with the computer system by just clicking, example Windows and Linux. This is the option where you just need to select and click, your work will be done. So class, today we have learned about the operating system uses operating system used as an interface between the user and the computer system, two types of interface, CUI and GUI. So next class we'll learn about operating system, and that is MS Windows.